Hi there! In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to create a graphic and modern poster design starting from an image of a bust. This kind of design is very similar to magazine visuals. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and leave a like. It'll motivate me to create and share more designs. Let's start by opening Photoshop with a poster format like A3. Then I'll import my image, which you can find on the free image bank, unsplash.com. We'll start by cropping our samurai armor bust. To do this, we'll go to the Selection tab, then Subject. Photoshop will directly detect the main subject of your image. But the selection will never be perfect on the first try, so we'll rework it with the Quick Selection tool and recover only the area we want. Once our selection is more or less complete, we'll apply a mask to our layer. To do this, click on the icon in the bottom right-hand corner. We're going to use the brush tool and erase with the color black the areas that best contour our bust. I'm going to skip ahead in the video to avoid you spending too much time on a boring manipulation. Now we're back to our nicely cropped image. I'm going to rework our image with Hue, Saturation, Effect Layers, then Brightness, Contrast, and finally, Level, the aim being to enhance and intensify the image so that it's easier to distinguish. Once set, we'll select these layers in our image and right-click to convert them into a Smart Object. I'll define my background color, which will be a white beige to recall the color of old paper. Then, using the Rectangle Shape tool, I'll draw a shape on the back of my image. Then, in Properties, I'll change the Fill parameter to Gradient. By selecting the little square, I can change the color I want to give my gradient. If I want to add one, simply click below the gradient and redefine my color. With the small slider under my gradient, I can change the angle of my gradient. Once redefined, I'll pass my shape layer under my samurai. Then I'll do a Ctrl plus T, and positioning my mouse so that a white mouse icon with a double arrow appears. I'll do a Shift plus left click, and move my shape downwards. This will distort the side of my shape and create a dynamic in my visual. To add a little depth to our background, I'll double-click on our shape slap to open the Layer Style panel. Here we'll add the Inner Shadow option and reduce the Distance and Choke options to 0. We'll need to increase the Size value and reduce the Shadow Intensity with Opacity. Now we'll also open the Layer Style panel of our samurai image by double-clicking on its layer. This time we'll start by adding the Drop Shadow option so that it detaches our image from our background. Then we'll add Bevel and Emboss. With the Inner Bevel option and the Smooth technique, then we'll adjust the parameters so that we create a light outline that detaches our image from the background. Finally, I'll add the Inner Glow option to create a very light contour light in my image to enhance the image's external luminosity. Once set, I confirm, then go to the Filter tab, then Camera Raw Filter. In this new panel, we can rework our image so that it comes out as well as possible. We'll start with the basic options, but the ones with the most impact will be texture, clarity, and dehaze, which will bring out the details in our image. To correct imperfections such as color artifacts, we can configure the details option, in which we can set noise reduction to reduce image noise, i.e. the pixelated blur effect. Once we're satisfied with the result, all we have to do is validate. We're going to lock our layers so that they don't get in the way of the manipulations that follow. Ren, I'm going to start by adding more detail to our visual, and we'll start with the title of our poster. Using the text tool, keyboard shortcut T, write my title, then find a typeface I like and place my text. We'll frame this text using the rectangle shape tool and draw a red rectangle to underline the title. Then, holding down Alt plus left click, I'll move and duplicate my rectangle at the top of the title. Selecting my two layers, I'll drag them under my samurai layer. Still using the rectangle shape tool, this time removing my red background and selecting a red outline. I'm going to draw a frame around my composition and then I'm going to shift its layer right below the other layers. From here, I'll speed up the video by simply rearranging the text in rectangle shapes. These elements will serve to structure my image and add dimension and depth to the visual. At the same time, I'm going to give some sense to the overall composition. It's important to pay attention to the overall composition and symmetry of your visual. To add Japanese calligraphy, you can simply copy and paste a translation from a translator and use a typeface that accepts calligraphy. Personally, I used a typeface called Yukiboku, which is free and comes from Google Font. I'm going to continue adding details to my visual. Once I've finished creating details in Photoshop, I'll group them into a clack group that I'll toggle under my main image. I'll create a new layer underneath all the others and with the brush tool, with hardness at minimum and size high, I'll create a black gradient. Then with a Ctrl plus T, I'll move it back so that it only darkens the bottom of my visual. This will allow me to add more details at the bottom of the visual, in this case text, which will be the continuation of the sentence at the top of my visual. From here, I'll open an Illustrator file where I've created vector shapes that I'll import and use in Photoshop to add details to my composition. As a reminder of Japanese designs, we're going to create a kind of sun with lines only. To do this, I'll use the feather tool to create a line, which I'll change to a thickness of 2. And then change the shape of the line, in this case to a triangular shape. Then, by pressing R for the rotate option, I'll click on my inner line point. This will be my new rotation point. Then, still using the rotation tool, I'll move my line by holding down the Alt key, which will allow me to duplicate my line at the same time as rotating it. Then we'll press the Ctrl plus D keys simultaneously and repeatedly to duplicate the last action until we create the desired shape. Once finished, we'll select all our lines and copy and paste them into Photoshop under our image layer. Then we'll double-click on this layer and in the Layer Style panel, I'll add the Color Overlay option in the same red as my other elements. From here on, I'm going to speed up the video even further, because as before, I'm simply going to import and place my elements one by one between Illustrator and Photoshop. Once I've finished importing my elements, I'll create a new layer and select a brush from Flare, which you can get for free on the internet. And with a white color, I'll create a luminous artifact that I'll place on the helmet of the armor. This will further detach my image while adding detail to the composition. We'll now move on to the texture part of our visual. I'm going to import various textures that will enable me to add details and make my visual more realistic. If you're interested in textures, I suggest you take a look at my online store, where you can download some for free, link in description. I'll start by importing a crumpled cardboard texture. I'll position it on top of my samurai image and under my gradient shape layer. Then I'll change its blend option to hard light, which will transfer only the dark parts of the texture to our visual. We'll rework this layer by adding a hue, saturation, effect layer and right-clicking on it to transform it into a clipping mask. This will put the effect inside the layer. I'll adjust my effect layer by reducing its saturation to -100 and increasing its lightness a little. Then I'll set a second effect layer, which will be a brightness contrast layer that I'll drag inside my texture layer. Once set, I'll drag my layer group with all my elements under this texture to make the effect more visible. We're going to add a second texture that will act as a frame and age the visual. This is an aluminum texture that I'm going to import on top of all the other layers. Then I'll change its blend mode to linear light and reduce its fill parameter to 33%. This will reduce the texture effect. I'm going to add a few more effect layers on top of all my other layers to clean up the overall look of the visual. I'll use vibrance, hue, saturation, and brightness contrast. Once reworked, we'll combine all our layers into a single group, then right-click on it to convert it into a smart object. Then we'll Ctrl plus A and copy-paste to select our entire work plan and duplicate it. We'll then convert this new layer back into a smart object. We'll finish our visual by reworking it a little more, for which we'll go to Filter, then Camera Raw. In this new panel, we'll go straight to Effects and add grain to our image. This will erase any defects and make our visual a little more realistic. Then we'll configure the vignetting option to create shading all around the poster so as to center our gaze. We can go back to the Basic tab and rework the intensity of our image if we're still not happy with it. Same for the Detail option. Once we're happy with our modifications, all we have to do is validate and we're done with our creation. And here's the final result. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me, I'll be delighted to help you. If you liked this video, please subscribe and leave a like. It will motivate me to create more tutorials of my creations. See you on the channel.